I will show you how to solve the problems you face when you do questions from this chapter, pretty much the easiest way possible. In almost all the cases, you will be given a graph and the question will ask you to find the position, velocity, or acceleration and draw the new graphs. There are 5 types of graphs you could be given. I will explain how to solve each of them. If you aren't given a graph, then it's still the same principle. You're just given the equations instead, or enough data to come up with your own equations. The first type of graph is the position versus time graph. This is probably the easiest of all the other graphs, because the solution to this problem will almost always include just derivatives. First, write down the equations of each segment given. Remember to use y equals mx plus b to figure out the equations. If the question asks for the velocity, take the derivative of each of the segments. That will give you the velocity, and you can plot the new equations on a velocity versus time graph. If the question asks for the acceleration, take the derivative of the velocity equations you just found. So you're just taking the derivative 2 times. Then you can plot the acceleration versus time graph using the new equations. The second type of graph is the velocity versus time graph. First, write down the equations of each of the segments given in the graph. You might get a bit lucky and the equations might be given to you, which will save you a few steps. Now, if the question asks for the position time graph or asks for the distance traveled, you must integrate. If, for example, the question only asks for the distance traveled and the graph is a simple linear graph, you can calculate the area under the graph by adding up the rectangular and triangular spaces underneath the graph. If it's not a linear graph, you have to take the integral of each segment. So for each position equation you have, take the integral. Let's take a look at a quick example. In this question, we want to draw the position versus time graph. The equations for each segment is v equals 12 over 30t and v equals 12. Remember that velocity is the derivative of position with respect to time. So you just need to write the equation as ds is equal to v dt. Most of the time, it will say the object started from rest and your lower bounds for the integral will be 0. In this example, you can see that velocity is 0 meters at a time value of 0 seconds, which also means it started from a displacement of 0 meters. So take the integral of the first segment. We get 12 over 60t squared. Once you solve the integral, you need to find the displacement at the time before the new segment starts. So looking at the graph, we see that the new segment starts at 30 seconds. Substitute 30 seconds in and we get a displacement value of 180 meters. So at 30 seconds, our object moved 180 meters. You need that as the lower bounds for the next integral. Always remember that when you find the new distance, time has elapsed. You need to change the lower bounds for both sides, distance and time. Then you take the integral for the next segment. You will now have 2 displacement equations. You can now plot them as a new graph. If it's asking for the distance traveled in a certain time, simply substitute the time into the displacement equation and the value you get is the distance traveled within that time. Remember to use the equation that corresponds to the correct time. So what I mean is, in this example, if the question asks how far the object traveled in 25 seconds, we need to use the first displacement equation because it represents displacement from 0 to 30 seconds. If it asks for the distance traveled in 40 seconds, then we need to use the second displacement equation. Let's focus on acceleration. If the question asks for the acceleration, you just take the derivative of your velocity equations, because acceleration is dv over dt, and you will get the acceleration equations for each segment. In this example, we get 12 over 30 meters per second squared for the first segment, and 0 meters per second squared for the second segment. You can then plot those versus time. The third type of graph is the acceleration versus time graph. As before, first write down the equations for each of the segments. If you need to find the velocity, you need to remember that acceleration is dv over dt. You can write it as dv is equal to adt. Then you need to integrate. Remember to substitute the value corresponding to the time where the new segment starts, which will be your new bounds for the next integral like we did before. Once you find the velocity equation and the question asks for the position, you need to integrate the velocity equation. That will give you the displacement equations. So in essence, you're taking the integral of the acceleration equations 2 times. Here is a small recap of how to go from one to the other. So for example, if you want to get the velocity from acceleration, then you need to integrate. But if you need to get the acceleration from velocity, then you need to take the derivative. Now, if you need to get the position from acceleration, then you need to integrate two times. The first integration gives you velocity, and the second integration gives you the position. The fourth type of graph is the velocity versus position graph. The first thing to do is write down the equations for each segment. In this example, the first segment is v equals 0.08s, and the second segment is v equals negative 0.08s plus 16. Let's find the acceleration of this object. For a question asking for acceleration from a velocity versus position graph, the only thing you need to remember is that ads is equal to vdv. We will focus on the first segment. First step is to take the derivative of the velocity equation. So dv over ds is equal to 0.08. Now we need to manipulate this to write it as dv is equal to 0.08ds. That's pretty much the trick to these types of problems. Then it's just substituting these into our equation. So ads is equal to vdv. The v part is 0.08s, and the dv part is 0.08ds. So we have ads is equal to 0.08s multiplied by 0.08ds. Cancel out the ds from both sides, and you have an acceleration equation. A is equal to 0.0064s. You didn't even have to take an integral. It's the same for the second segment. Take the derivative of the velocity equation. We get dv over ds is equal to negative 0.08. We can write it as dv is equal to negative 0.08ds. Now we just need to put this into our ads is equal to vdv equation. We have ads is equal to negative 0.08s plus 16 multiplied by negative 0.08ds. Cancel out the ds and simplify to get our acceleration equation. Now you can plot the acceleration equations or find an acceleration value at a specific time. The other problem they might ask for is to draw a position versus time graph from the velocity versus position graph. Let's look at this new example where we have the equations given to us. For this, remember that velocity is equal to ds over dt. We need to isolate dt, so we can write it as dt is equal to ds over v. Now we need to have time on the left side, so we need to integrate. In other words, we need to change dt to t. And the way to do that is to integrate. So we have the following integral. All we did was simply substitute our velocity equation to v. The lower bounds are 0 seconds, and the displacement is 0 meters. Don't get confused here, it's simply 1 over the velocity equation. Solve the integral, and you will have an equation for time. Since we need it to be an equation for displacement, we need to isolate our equation for s instead. So changing it gives us an equation for displacement with respect to time. The next step, as with other problems where we took the integral, is to find the displacement value at the time when the new segment starts. So we need to substitute 100 meters and solve for t. We get a time value of 10 seconds. Now we can write the integral for the next segment as before. The lower bounds are 10 seconds and 100 meters. Solve the integral and isolate for s, and you will get the displacement equation for the last segment. The fifth type of graph is the acceleration versus position graph. As always, write down the equations of each segment. Just as the fourth type of graph, this one also requires you to remember ads is equal to vdv. The question will most likely ask you to draw the velocity versus displacement graph. In this sample problem, the two equations for the segments are a equals 2 over 200s and a is equal to 2. All we need to do is substitute this into our equation and take the integral. So we end up with this integral. Remember that lower bounds are 0 because the train starts at a displacement of 0 meters and the velocity is 0 at s equals 0. This is usually given to us in the question. Solve the integral. Now it's just a matter of isolating for v by taking the square root of both sides. As always, you need to substitute the value at which the new segment starts. In this problem, it's at 200 meters. So the velocity of the train at 200 meters is 20 meters per second. Now for the next segment. We just do the same as before, this time a equals 2. The lower bounds are the values we calculated, which are 200 meters and 20 meters per second. Solve this integral and then isolate for v. Now you can plot the velocity versus displacement graph. These are the five graphs you will face when you solve questions from this section. In all cases, you're just taking the integrals or derivatives and just isolating for a variable. I hope this helped you, and if it did, please give a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.